guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this particular video, I will be discussing to you the VAT on sale of real properties. Okay, so during our previous videos, we always discuss that every time we sell goods, properties, or services, and as long as the sale was made in the ordinary course of trade or business, it will be subject to VAT unless exempt under the law. So that basic guide will also apply in sale of real properties. Okay? So of course, also in our discussion in VAT exempt sales and transactions, we already discussed those real properties that are exempt from VAT under the law. So therefore, what we are going to do here is to illustrate how to compute the applicable output VAT in relation to real properties. Okay? So let's proceed. As a rule, sale of real property primarily held for sale in the normal course of trade or business, or maybe for lease in the ordinary course of trade, is subject to value-added tax. Of course, the rate is 12% as discussed in our previous videos. Nonetheless, what will be the basis of the 12% VAT? So, sa mga previous videos natin, pag yan ay sale of goods, gross sales. Pag yan ay sale of service, gross receipts. However, with respect to real properties, the basis will be selling price or the fair market value provided by the city provincial assessors na tinatawag din nating assessed value. Yan yung valuation used for purposes of computing the real property tax sa LGU natin, or the zonal valuation as provided by the BIR, whichever is the highest amount among those figures. Okay? So, yun yung magiging basis ng 12% VAT natin, selling price, o kaya zonal value, o kaya fair market value provided by the city provincial assessors. Okay, next. Aside from knowing the basis of the 12% VAT with respect to sale of real property, we will discuss the different types of sales for purposes of value-added tax. And there are three under the tax code. We have the cash basis, as shown in your screen right now, the deferred payment basis, and the installment basis. Siyempre, pag sinabi natin cash basis, if we are the seller, we will be paid in full right away. O, yan yung cash basis. Ano naman significance niyan, sir, sa topic natin na VAT? Anong significance ng classifying the sale as cash sale, deferred sale, installment sale? So, this has something to do with how much or what percentage of the VAT or the output VAT shall we report to the BIR. Okay? So, ganito lang yan. Siyempre, kung cash basis yung sale mo, fully paid ka naman, di ba? So, in that case, we need to report the entire output VAT right away during the month or quarter na ginawa natin yung sale na yon, natural. Okay? So, ulitin ko, kailan natin, o how much of the output VAT shall be reported or remitted to the BIR? The answer to that is, anong klaseng sale ba yan? Kasi kung cash sale yan, i-report natin lahat-lahat yung buong output VAT niyan during the month of the sale. 12% of the selling price, zonal, or fair market value as previously discussed a while ago. Okay? Yes, sir. Paano kung hindi cash basis? Utang. So, kung pautang yan, dalawang klase yan. May tinatawag na deferred sale saka installment sale. Kailan deferred sale, kailan installment sale? Depende kung ano ang ratio ng initial payment over selling price. Kung ang ratio ng initial payment over selling price ay hindi lagpas 25%, installment sale yan. Pero kung ang ratio ng initial payment over selling price ay lagpas 25%, deferred sale yan. So, ano ang magiging tax consequence kung ganon? So, ganito tayo. Dito muna tayo sa deferred sale. It is called deferred sale, again, if yung ratio ng initial payment over selling price ay lagpas 25%. If it will fall under this category of sale, we will treat it as cash sale. So kahit pinautang mo yan, pero ang initial payment ay lagpas 25%, you need to report pa rin yung buong output VAT in the month, okay, the transaction was made, or during the month of the sale, or quarter. Okay? So, maliwanag ba yon? So, kahit pautang yan, ha? Pero ang initial ratio, ha? Lagpas 25%, ha? Initial ratio ng initial payment over selling price, ha? Tinatawag din yan na deferred sale. Treat it as cash sale. We report the entire output VAT in the year or in the month of sale or during the month of sale. So, you must know kung ano ang laman ng initial payment. Okay? And obviously, divide that with the selling price. Paano naman, sir, kung ang ratio ng initial payment over selling price ay hindi naman lagpas 25%. Yan naman yung pasok sa installment sale. So kung pasok yan sa installment sale, ang ire-report mo lang na output VAT ay corresponding to your collections. Halimbawa, ang initial payment, 20% lang. So ang output VAT mo na ire-report mo sa BIR will only pertain to your collection. Okay? So, hindi mo kailangan i-report yung output VAT ng buong selling price o na ang buong zonal value. Ang i-report mo lang is corresponding to your collection. Kaya napaka-crucial itong type of sale kung hindi siya ka-sale. Deferred sale ba yan o installment sale? So, therefore, dapat alam mo kung ano ang ibig sabihin or how to compute initial payment. So, initial payment is composed of number one, your down payment. Number two, lahat ng collections during the year of sale. And if applicable, penalties, interest, and excess of mortgage over cost. Add mo lahat yon, and that will be your initial payment. Kung yung klase ng sale ay papasok sa installment sale, ang VAT na i-report sa unang taon ay yung base sa initial payment. Tapos, yung mga subsequent years, based na siya sa collection. So, ulitin ko ha, kung papasok sa category ng installment sale, yung pagbebenta ng real property, ang output VAT due during the year will be based on the initial payment. Multiply mo yun ng 12%. Okay? So, let's illustrate the computation ng output VAT pertaining to sale of real property in the ordinary course of trade or business natural. Kasi the moment na ang binenta mo na real property ay hindi in the ordinary course of trade or business, eh, capital gains tax yun, as discussed in our previous videos. Diba? Okay. So, this is how you're going to compute your output VAT. Sabi nga natin kanina, sa year of sale, ang gagamitin ay initial payment. This is if the sale will be classified as installment sale. Kasi kung yan ay hindi installment sale, halimbawa, cash sale, you don't need this formula kasi 12% lang yan ng selling price or zonar or FMV, whichever is the highest among those amounts. Eh sir, deferred sale. Eh kung deferred sale, di ba treated as cash sale yon? So, kung deferred sale yan, cash sale ang equivalent. O, edi multiply mo lang ng 12% yung selling price, zonal, or fair market value provided by the city or provincial assessor. Pero kung installment sale, we don't do that. Dahil installment sale yan, yung VAT mo will be based on your collection. Pero, yung unang taon, ang basis is not simply collection, kundi initial payment. Initial payment over selling price times the higher between GSP and FMV. Huwag kayong malito ha sa, sir, kasi kung minsan ginagamit nila whichever is the higher between selling price and fair market value. Tapos kung minsan naman, kagaya ng tinukoy mo kanina, whichever is the highest amount among selling price, fair market value provided by the city or provincial assessor, saka zonal valuation by the BIR. Kasi, the moment na sinabi mong FMV lang, okay, pag sinabi mong FMV lang, we are pertaining to the higher between the assessed value or the FMV given by the provincial or city assessor and the zonal value given by the BIR. Kaya yung pag sinabi mong higher between GSP and FMB, and FMB dapat yan, ha? Hindi or pala. So, higher between the two. Higher between GSP and FMB. So, pag sinabi natin FMB, dalawa na ang laman yan. Yun sa, ulitin ko, city assessor, saka provincial assessor, saka yung zonal valuation by the BIR. Okay? So, again, you need to memorize the component of the initial payment. Tapos yung subsequent years, hindi na siya initial payment. Okay? Collection na yan over selling price times higher between the two. Sir, matanong ko kayo, pwede bang wala ng over gross selling price? Pwede bang collection na lang times the higher between the two? Or collection times 12%? Pwede yon, collections times 12%. Kung pinakamataas na halaga yung selling price. However, the moment na mas mataas yung assessed value or zonal value, you need to follow the formula. Kaya I really suggest you memorize the formula. Okay, I hope maliwanag. So, pag nagbenta tayo ng real properties, classify it. Okay, ka-sale, deferred sale, installment sale. Of course, may VAT yan kung yung pagbebenta was made in the ordinary course, okay, of trade or business. So, bago natin tapusin itong video na to, so as you can see, medyo shorter ito kaysa sa ibang videos natin. So, bago natin tapusin to, let's illustrate. So, a real estate dealer, pasensya na sa PowerPoint, hindi ko lang nalagyan ng space, okay, a real tuloy. A real estate dealer showed the following details during the year. So, wag ko nang palitan yung PowerPoint ko just because of that na. Anyway, video naman to. So, as you can see, we are discussing. So, balik ako. A real estate dealer showed the following details during the year. So, ang ginawa kong example ng year of sale, 2021, ha? Kasi medyo hindi maganda itong 2020 natin, eh. Kaya ang ginawa ko na lang dyan, year 2021. Sana matapos na nga ang mga problema natin ngayong 2020, ano? So, I hope everyone is safe. Sige, balik tayo. So, the year of sale is 2021, specifically June 1. Consideration or selling price is 5 million. The assessed value is 4.8 and the zonal is 5.2. So as you can see, the highest among the three amounts ay 5.2. So we will be using 5.2. In fact, kung hindi utang yan, ang VAT niyan ay simply 5.2 million times 12%, di ba? Kung cash sale yan, how much is the VAT? 5.2 times 12%. When do we report? June. Okay, June 1, 2021. Pero ang June ay pasok sa second quarter. Kaya pasok siya sa second quarterly filing and payment. Okay? So, let's proceed. However, ano kasi ito? Ang nangyari ay pautang. So, yung iba, babaya, makokolekta ngayon 2021, 1 million ngayon 2021, 2 million sa 2022, and another 2 million sa 2023. Ang tanong, magkano ang output tax to be recognized for June 1, 2021, 2022, 2023? So, we need to know first kung ano ang ratio ng initial payment over selling price. So, ang initial payment is, di ba, down payment plus all collections during year of sale, including excess of mortgage over cost, if any, pati interest and penalty. So, wala naman yung mga ibang items na yon. You were given only one amount and that is 1 million. So, yun na yung initial payment mo for 2021. So, i-divide mo yung 1 million na initial payment over selling price. So, 1 over 5. If we do that, ang ratio, as you can see in your screen, is 20%. At di ba sabi natin, pag 20%, so hindi siya lagpas sa 25%. So, installment sale yan. So, kung installment sale yan, pwedeng hindi mo i-report agad-agad yung buong output VAT pertaining to 5.2 million. Pwede siyang, okay, pa unti-unti based on your collection and initial payment. So, magkano ang i-report natin na output VAT sa 2021? So, dahil pasok sa installment sale, o ganito mangyayari, 1 million as your initial payment, over 5 million as your selling price, di ba? Times the highest amount is 5.2, di ba? So, times 5.2 million, times 12%. So, instead of paying or reporting the entire 624,000 na output VAT sa year 2021, ang ire-report lang natin, 124,800. And then sa 2022, as you can see in your screen, 249,600. And another 249,600 sa 2023. For a total of 624. So kumbaga parang instead na binayaran mo minsanan yung 624, ang nangyari, binayaran mo sa tatlong taon. Kaya dapat ang total nung 3 years na yan, 624. Kaya as you can see in your screen, you can check your answer. Sir, ulitin ko, paano po sir kung cash sale ko binenta yan? Ah, yung 624, i-report mo lahat yan sa June. Sir, pautang din. Pero alam mo, ang initial payment sa 2021 ay hindi 1 million. Halimbawa, sir, 2 million. Kung 2 million yon, 40% na kasi 2 over 5. Kung 40% deferred sale na yon. Kung deferred sale na yon, para ka na rin nagbenta on a cash basis. So, kung ganun ang senaryo, yung 624, kailangan i-report mo lahat sa month of June. Okay? So, ganun lang naman yung VAT on sale of real property. So, I hope naliwanagan ko kayo lahat. Okay? So, that's all for this particular video. So, I hope kung natututo naman tayo sa mga videos na sineshare natin, I hope you will subscribe and like it as well. Okay? So again, thank you very much. Let's all stay safe. God bless you all.